Class 12, Current Electricity, Important Formula, Part 3, 22nd Formula, Kirchhoff's First Law, that is summation of I is equal to 0, that is I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus etc. up to IN is equal to 0. For example, we can take a current I1 moving towards the junction O and I2 moving away from the junction O and I3 the current moving towards the junction. I1, I2 ungrathu current entering into the junction O, that should be taken as positive. And I3 current moving away from the junction, that should be taken as negative. So applying Kirchhoff's first law in this diagram, I1 moving towards the junction O, so plus I1. Then I3 moving towards the junction, so plus I3. I2 moving away from the junction, so minus I2, that is equal to 0. Then that can be written as I1 plus I3 is equal to I2 minus I2 at the same position plus I2. So current moving towards the junction is equal to current away from the junction. 23rd formula, Kirchhoff's second law, is otherwise known as voltage law or loop rule. In the other one, Kirchhoff's first law is otherwise called as current law, Kirchhoff's current law or junction rule. Now, formula la solla marandute, Kirchhoff's first law is otherwise called as Kirchhoff's voltage law or junction rule. Kirchhoff's second law is otherwise called as Kirchhoff's voltage law or loop rule. That is, summation of delta V is equal to 0. What is delta V? V is the potential difference. That is, I1 R1 plus I2 R2 plus I3 R3 plus etc. up to IN RN is equal to E1 plus E2 plus etc. up to EN. I1, I2, I3, etc. IN are the current passing through the closed loop. And R1, R2, R3, etc. up to RN are the resistance of the corresponding resistors. Then E1, E2, etc. up to EN are the EMF of the cells, EMF of each cell. Then 24th formula, balancing condition for Wheatstone bridge. This is the Wheatstone bridge. I am considering 4 resistors. Of resistances P, Q, R and S connected to form a series. This is called Wheatstone bridge, and a kilometer is connected between the junctions B and D, and this ABCD is connected to the battery of potential difference V. Then the current will pass from positive terminal to the negative terminal. Okay, so what is the balancing condition for Wheatstone bridge? P by Q is equal to R by S. This is the Wheatstone bridge balance condition. 25th formula, unknown resistance in meter bridge. S, unknown resistance, S, capital S, is equal to 100 minus small l divided by small l whole multiplied by capital R. Here, L is the balancing length, meter, its unit is meter, R, capital R is the known resistance, unit ohm. Capital S is the unknown resistance, its unit is ohm. Okay, so unknown resistance can be calculated by using meter bridge. S is equal to 100 minus L by L into R. S is the unknown resistance, R is the known resistance, L is the balancing length. 26th formula, comparison of two unknown resistances using potentiometer. R1 by R2 is equal to L2 by L1 into 100 minus L1 by 100 minus L2. Here R1 and R2 are the unknown resistances, its unit is ohm, and L1 and L2 are the balancing length, its unit is meter. 27th formula, unknown temperature in meter bridge. Unknown temperature get T. So T degree Celsius is equal to R minus R0 by R100 minus R0 into 100. R minus R0 by R100 minus R0 whole multiplied by 100 ma. Where capital R is the known resistance and its unit is ohm. R0 resistance at 0 degree Celsius. That is unit ohm. R100 is the resistance at 100 degree Celsius. 100 degree Celsius is the boiling point of water. Okay, its unit is also ohm. T is the unknown resistance. So, unknown temperature can be calculated by using meter bridge by using this formula. T degree Celsius is equal to R minus R0 by R100 minus R0 whole multiplied by 100. Then 28th formula, principle of potentiometer. V is directly proportional to L. This implies V is equal to XL, where V is the potential drop across any portion of wire. Okay, 100 meter wire, எந்த இடத்துலனாலும் உள்ள பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிராப் வி இஸ் த பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிராப் அக்ராஸ் எனி போர்ஷன் ஆஃப் ஒயர் தட் 100 மீட்டர் ஒயரில் எந்த இடத்துலனாலும் உள்ள அந்த பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிராப் கேபிட்டல் எல் லென்த் ஆஃப் த போர்ஷன் ஆஃப் ஒயர் அப்போ சொன்ன மாதிரி தான் 100 மீட்டர் ஒயரில் 10 செக்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் ஒவ்வொன்றில் என்ன செஞ்சு சாரி 10 மீட்டர் ஒயர்மா சாரி அப்போ 100 மீட்டர்னு சொல்லிட்டு போன பார்மனால தப்பு 10 meter wire, 10 segment of which over meter. Capital L is the length of the portion of wire meter. முந்தர் இதில் ஒரு சின்ன தப்புமா, V இங்கிருது potential across any part of the wire இங்கிருது 100 meter தப்பா சொல்லிட்டேன். 100 meter கடியாது, 10 meter and it is divided into 10 segment each of 1 meter. அப்படிங்கும் போது, V இங்கிருது potential across any part of the wire. அது மாறு இங்க capital L இங்கிருது length of the portion of wire that is meter and the 10 meter la enda portion la irukra length enga balance avaro and the length da enna solluvanga l of the wire meter x is the potential gradient what do you mean the potential gradient fall of potential per unit length of wire that is potential per that is dv by dx nu paangama erkana solirukom anything that varies with distance that is called gradient so here potential varies with the distance so it is called potential gradient அப்படின்னா potential divided by its length potential ஓட யூனிட் volt length ஓட யூனிட் வந்து மீட்டர் so V by M volt per meter is the unit of potential gradient then 29th formula balancing condition of potentiometer that is E is directly proportional to L to remove the proportionality we are adding one constant that constant is called small x is the potential gradient we know already potential gradient unit is volt per meter and small l is the balancing length its unit is meter m and e capital e is the emf of cell in galvanometer circuit with jacky its unit is also volt so what is the balancing condition of potentiometer e is directly proportional to l inge l ingirad length of the wire inge l ingirad small l ingirad balancing length ingeyo x potential gradient da munduna case le x potential gradient da so balancing condition of potentiometer is e is equal to xl 30th formula potential difference using potentiometer capital V is equal to capital E by capital L into small l here V is the potential difference its unit is volt it is represented by the capital letter V capital E is the EMF of cell its unit is also volt and it is represented by the letter capital V capital L is the length of the portion of wire that is meter and small l is the balancing length meter balancing length oda unit meter 31st comparison of EMFs of two cells individual cell method using potentiometer now ஏற்கனவே ஒரு ஃபார்முலால ஒரு சின்ன தப்பு பண்ணிருக்கமா அந்த தப்பை நீ கரெக்ட் பண்ணிக்கோ 26th ஃபார்முலா எடுத்து பாத்துக்கோ 26th ஃபார்முலா comparison of two unknown resistance using potentiometer னு சொல்லிருப்பேன் அந்த using potentiometer potentiometer அடிச்சிட்டு அந்த இடத்துல மீட்டர் பிரிட்ஜ் னு எழுதிக்கோங்கமா இந்த நம்ம முந்தின வீடியோல இதே இதுல முந்தின பார்ட்ல என்ன பண்ணிருப்பேன் 26th formula comparison of two unknown resistance using potentiometer and the potentiometer is the meter bridge this is the comparison of EMF of two cells using potentiometer that is E1 by E2 is equal to L1 by L2 E1 E2 is the EMF of the two cells its unit is volt represented by the capital letter V L1 L2 balancing length its unit is meter represented by the letter small m ala na adulochko comparison of emf of two cells using potentiometer e1 by e2 is equal to l1 by l2 26th formula vandu comparison of two unknown resistances that is using meter bridge anga thappa nama potentiometer nu potuta adu adichittu meter bridge nu eduthukom 32nd formula comparison of emfs of two cells munnadi paathadhu comparison of emf of two cells individual cell method individual cell method la nama e1 by e2 is equal to l1 by l2 nu paathom ipo nama paak pora sum and difference method that is e1 by e2 is equal to l1 plus l2 by l1 minus l2 ma l1 plus l2 that is the sum and l1 minus l2 difference so sum and difference method la e1 by e2 is equal to l1 plus l2 by l1 minus l2 where E1 and E2 are the EMF of two cells, EMF of two cells, that is electromotive force of two cells, its unit is volt and it is represented by the capital letter V. L1 and L2 are the balancing lengths, its unit is meter represented by the small letter M. 33rd, internal resistance of cell using potentiometer. internal resistance of cell is represented by the small letter R. That is equal to L1 minus L2 by L2 whole multiplied by capital R. Here capital R is the external resistance, its unit is ohm. And L1 and L2 are the balancing lengths and its unit is meter, and it is represented by the small letter M.